Hi, my name is Jeff Shapiro, and I'd like to welcome you to the first Arduino Learning Board video. This first video will introduce you to the Arduino platform and the Arduino Learning Board project. The remaining videos will become more hands-on and take you through connecting, programming, and experimenting with the Learning Board and all of the sensors included in the kit. In this video, I'll start with an explanation of what is Arduino, and then move on to the specifics of the Arduino Learning Board project. After that, I'll cover the skills you'll be learning, and finally provide additional information about Arduino. While some of you may already be familiar with Arduino, I'd like to start with a little background information for those who may have heard the word Arduino, but don't really know what it is. Arduino can be defined as an open source prototyping platform built around easy-to-use hardware and software. Okay, so what exactly does that mean? First, open source means that nothing is kept secret or proprietary from the public. What this means for us as developers or hobbyists is that we can choose, like most people do, to purchase one of the more popular Arduino boards, or you can download the schematics and create your own designs based on the Arduino reference designs if you choose. Arduino was created in 2005 by a team in Italy. It was originally created to be an easy tool for fast prototyping and was aimed at students that didn't necessarily have a background in electronics and programming. Currently, Arduino has been used as the controller or brain of thousands of projects, from everyday objects to complex scientific instruments. Projects could be as simple as turning an LED on and off, to building a small robot, to even controlling a quadcopter drone. Now that we have a little background on Arduino, let's move on to what likely brought you here, the Arduino Learning Board project. So what exactly is the Arduino Learning Board project? This project consists of a custom Arduino-based prototyping board, over 15 different sensors and parts, and this set of instructional videos. I created this project in part because of my own frustrating experiences learning to use sensors I've purchased online that came with little or no documentation, as well as to share my knowledge and enable others to begin creating their own projects. To accomplish my goal of creating the learning board, project kit, and instructional videos, I created and launched a Kickstarter campaign on April 18, 2016. 45 days later, on June 2nd, I successfully raised over 177% of my funding goal with the help of 345 backers. So what exactly is the Arduino Learning Board? As you'll soon learn, while most Arduino-based boards are built around the same or very similar technology and provide similar functionality, they differ in shape, size, and number of inputs and outputs, and how you connect them to power and to your computer for transferring programming instructions. Depending on what you're building, you can choose the particular Arduino board or module that best fits your needs. In our case, our task or goal is to learn to connect, operate, and experiment with a varied collection of sensors. To accomplish this goal, I created the Arduino Learning Board. This board combines the popular Arduino Nano module with a solderless breadboard, LEDs, switches, and full access to all functions of the Arduino. To simplify the Arduino development process, I like to think about projects as consisting of three parts: inputs, outputs, and logic. We start by examining inputs, or data coming in from devices like buttons, switches, temperature sensors, joysticks, and other sensors. Then we make decisions and apply logic to that data. Finally, we create outputs in response to those inputs to devices like LEDs, LCD displays, buzzers, motors, etc. A more programmatic way to think about it is with if-then logic. For example, you may want to create a buzzer to let you know that you've forgotten to close the refrigerator door. Using a temperature sensor and a buzzer, you could create a simple program to say if the temperature inside my refrigerator is above 37 degrees Fahrenheit, then turn on the buzzer. Likewise, if the temperature of my refrigerator is below 37 degrees, then turn off the buzzer. We'll see specific examples of using if-then logic once we get started programming our Arduino. To use sensors, buttons, switches, and other devices with the learning board, we'll be using jumper wires, sometimes called DuPont wire. When we start building our first projects, you'll see exactly how to use jumper wires to connect and create circuits without soldering and without any tools. Some of the sensors we'll be using as inputs to our Arduino project are temperature and humidity sensor, PS2 style joystick, 4-button touch sensor, 3-axis gyroscope, sonar range sensor, real-time clock, sound sensor, tilt sensor, and an RFID kit. Some of the sensors we'll be using as outputs from our Arduino projects are LEDs, LCD display, 7-segment display, both single-digit and 4-digit, a buzzer, relay module, servo motor, and a stepper motor. As I mentioned earlier, the Arduino comes in various standard models, including the Arduino Uno, Nano, Pro, Pro Mini, Mega, Zero, etc. Most are based on the Atmel ARM microcontroller and operate at either 3.3 volts or 5 volts. Most of our sensors operate at 5 volts, but many will only handle 3.3 volts, so you can choose the right model for a particular project. Even though there are numerous variations of Arduino boards, they all share similar inputs and outputs. And again, after you've defined what your project is going to do and have chosen your sensors, you can then choose an Arduino model based on those requirements. All Arduino models have pins that you make connections with. These pins have various functions, including power, digital inputs, analog inputs, digital outputs, and pulse width modulation output, or PWM. Other signals may include reset, voltage references, or serial data. Digital signals, either inputs or outputs, are signals that can either be on or off. In a 5-volt Arduino, the on or high digital input or output will be 5 volts. And on a 3.3 volt Arduino, an on or high digital value will be represented by 3.3 volts. In both cases, an off or low digital value will be 0 volts, or what we also call ground. An analogy for digital signals is a simple light switch. If the switch is on, the light is on. If the switch is off, the light is off. Analog signals, on the other hand, are like having a dimmer switch. You can still have full on or full off, but you can also have many different values in between. In Arduino, we typically can represent 1,024 different values between 0 and 5 volts. Or between 0 and 3.3 volts on a 3.3 volt Arduino. We'll see this soon when we experiment with the joystick project. Lastly, PWM stands for pulse width modulation. This is when you switch an output, usually very rapidly, between its on and off states. The ratio of on time versus off time is often used to represent a value or to give the appearance that an LED is being dimmed. The Arduino Uno is one of the most popular Arduino boards, certainly for people new to Arduino. We're actually going to use a different board, but let's start by looking at the Arduino Uno. All programming is done on a computer and transferred to the Arduino board through a standard USB cable. This board, like many of the other Arduino boards, is based on the Atmel ATmega328P controller. It has 14 digital inputs and outputs, most of which can be configured as either an input or output based on your project's needs. 6 of those pins can produce PWM, or pulse width modulated output. There are six analog inputs used to read voltages between 0 and the board's operating voltage. The Uno runs at 16 MHz, has a USB port, power jack, and a built-in reset button. These images show the differences between the Arduino Uno I just described and the Arduino Nano, which we'll be using. The Arduino Nano uses the same processor as the Uno, and any programs or projects that you can do on an Uno work exactly the same on a Nano. Some differences are the Nano does not have a DC power jack. Power for this board comes either from the mini USB jack on the Nano or can be supplied through power pins on the board. The Nano has a mini USB connector rather than a standard USB, and as you can see from the photo, is smaller than the Uno. The biggest difference, and one of the biggest reasons why you may choose a Nano versus an Uno, is that you can plug the Nano directly into a solderless breadboard, if that's how you plan to prototype your project. The Nano has pins for easy connection to other circuits, while the Uno has sockets that you can wire to directly. Here's a larger image of the Arduino Nano with an explanation of all of its pins. Going more by function than pin by pin, we have the VIN, or voltage input pin. While not being powered by the USB port, you can supply between 7 and 12 volts to the VIN pin to operate the Arduino. The Nano will convert the voltage you supply to both the 5 volts and 3.3 volts to run the Arduino and any external sensors. The 5 volt pin is usually used as an output, but if not using USB as a source of power, you can supply 5 volts directly to this pin. The RST pins can be used to reset the Arduino by connecting it to ground. There's also a small button in the center of the Arduino Nano hooked up to this pin, so you can easily reset the Nano by just pushing the built-in reset button. The 3.3 volt pin provides a 3.3 volt output. D2 through D13 can be used as digital inputs or outputs. The A0 through A7 are the analog inputs. VREF can be used along with analog inputs to provide a reference voltage for those inputs. And the RX and TX pins provide access directly to the serial port. Lastly, ground is the module's ground pin. Congratulations on completing the first video. The second video will go into more detail of the Arduino Learning Board and how to create your very first program. Please remember to visit www.arduinolearningboard.com to keep up with the project and to access all of the videos and information you will need to complete the projects. Thank you again.